Final Cut Pro 11 that one just dropped, and I think the updates are pretty good. They're not like the most wow updates. Here is the full list right here, and today I'm gonna share what I like in this list. I think there are some good ones here, so let's get it. This one right here is my favorite new feature, Native Adjustment Layer. Final Cut calls it Adjustment Clips, but it's Adjustment Layers. Just hit Option A, and it's gonna drop on top of your clip. Here's a real example. Let's just pick one of these effects here, maybe this one, and let's put it in our adjustment clip. You can drag it or double click it as usual, and there you go. You can see the whole effects now with the clips under the adjustment clip. Now let's play around with the transform settings. I think this one is pretty cool. I have a vertical clip here, and I'm gonna change the scale and the Y axis. Now check that out. All of these clips moved. I didn't have to click on them and then make the changes in the inspector, in the video inspector. Instead of plugging in the numbers one clip at a time, I just used the adjustment clip. And there you go. I had this 15-minute interview talking headshot. It's already cut. It's from the same set. And instead of grading each clip, I just dropped one adjustment clip on top and did all the color correcting and grading in there. I added my LUT and I'm done. If you select a group of clips, then choose an effect from the browser and press Option A. Final Cut will create an adjustment clip with that effect pre-applied and label it with the effect name. So now when you look at it on your timeline, you know what's in it and why you put it there. Guys, this one and the magnetic mask, I think, are two of the new features that I'm really excited about. This is gonna be added to my workflow for sure. They also added dynamic title templates. So if you scroll down in the title sidebar here, you'll see a fresh batch of options. And yes, they're fully customizable. Fonts, colors, animation styles, you name it. You can tweak them all in the title inspector, of course. You can play around with it. I haven't yet, but it looks like you can create a cool intro or a quick animated title with this. Next, you can now move timeline markers. Drag them around, reposition them as needed. And yes, you can delete them by just dragging them off like this, click and drag them off, but you can't move them from one clip to another. Like, you can only drag and move them around the selected clip where you put it first. This one comes straight out of Logic Pro. Basically, it makes your audio sound like it was recorded in different spaces like studios, concert halls. You apply it like any other filter and hit the UI icon and boom, you've got a panel with presets and custom controls if you want to fine tune it. Let's pick this option right here and listen. You got this. Okay. What about this one? You got this. I'll get back to this in another video. This gives me some idea. I think it's a pretty cool update. But let's move to the next one. You can now rename your audio effects. I don't know why they just didn't add this with the updates where you can name your video effects. Well, we all know that's how Final Cut Pro rolls, so there you go. This one's interesting. And I think like it's a trend right now, every platform tries to do something like this. But Apple added an AI photo generation tool inside Final Cut Pro. It's here under the import dropdown, which is kind of weird placement, but hey, it's there. You can also use a reference image and it'll generate an image and drop it right into your browser for you. There is always a creative way to use these kind of things. And yes, they also fixed some bugs in Final Cut Pro. But that's it. Let me know in the comment section which feature you're most excited to use. And if you got any value from this one, subscribe and like and do all that stuff. And I'll see you in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.